Hello everyone, and welcome to my first ever Cedar Point vlog. I'm here in the car with my mom. She's driving. Say hi, Mom.
Hi.
Okay. As we all know, you never film yourself and drive. That's dangerous. Plus, I can't drive anyway, so. Okay. My mom and I have gold passes, and this is the first time we've been able to go to Cedar Point since this whole COVID thing started. So, although I don't plan on having themes for these vlogs, I guess you could say the theme is what it's like to go to Cedar Point during COVID. And I'm sure you have lots of questions, and I will try and get to all of them over the course of this vlog while riding all the good rides and eating some of those great Cedar Point French fries. So, let's get right into it. Okay, so we just got to the park. We're in the parking spot 28A. I'm saying it out loud so I don't forget it. And if you look out, you can see all the rides that I'm probably not gonna ride. Isn't that cool? So one thing you might be wondering is, do you have to wear a mask to the parks? And the answer is yes. I mean, I'm wearing a mask right now, so is my mom. And pro tip from Christina, in your park bag, pack extra masks because you don't want to look like Bobo the Fool if your only mask falls off on Cedar Creek Mine Ride. And also, this is for all the time, wear sunscreen. Unless you're going during holiday weekends, sunscreen is a very important part of the theme park experience here in Ohio because it gets very hot. So, and now we just have to wait for our health screening.
They're using an access pass system to get on three rides, Maverick, Millennium Force, and Steel Vengeance.
They have markers here for social distancing, and we are about to enter into the health screening pavilion. As far as I can tell, these markers are 6 feet apart, but I don't really have a concept of what 6 feet is, so I'm just taking their word for it. So the health screening, we just went through it. It was pretty easy. They just had us walk through. There was a temperature checker on hand, but neither my mom nor me had it to do that. Now we're...
Good, thank you.
Okay. And we just got checked in the metal detector, so now it looks like we're ready to enter the park.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the place we have all been waiting for. The Mac Shack, a restaurant devoted to macaroni and cheese, one of my personal favorite foods. I would love to go here, see what it's all about. Unfortunately, the Mac Shack is closed for today, but stay tuned because in a future vlog, we'll probably have to go here.
You have just gotten in line for our first ride of the day, the Ferris wheel. It's gonna be lit. One perk of going right now is that the lines are not long. Well, granted the lines for, there aren't really long lines for anything since half the rides aren't even open yet. But I digress. So we just finished riding the giant wheel. Basically, for every six carts, they took two different groups on. So it was great because we got to go around a bunch of times and we rarely got stopped. So next up, we're about to go on the Tiki Twirl. It's gonna be great.
Right down the right way.
I just went on the Tiki Twirl and then the bumper cars. I was going to try and go on Troika, but it is not open at the moment. So what I think they're doing over here is that they're staggering the openings of different rides to kind of try and spread people out, which is probably a good idea. But hopefully we will be able to hit up the Troika later.
So my mom's going to try and get us some French fries. For those of you who are not as familiar with Cedar Point, their French fries are like the most famous thing they serve, and for good reason. They're very good fries. So, Mom, what happened with the fries? It's not open? Okay, looks like fries are gonna be for later, folks.
So, if you look inside of this candy place, you can actually see them making different treats like chocolate covered pretzels and Rice Krispies. Currently the store is open, but occupancy is limited.
So we are about to go on the Scrambler, which is always a fun time. As I'm going to show you real soon, they have queue markers just like the ones that they had before entering the park.
We just went on the Scrambler. One important thing to note is that they will let you off of the ride in a staggered way. Like, they'll be like, oh, people in carts like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 can get off now, instead of letting everyone off at once. So now I'm about to go ride the Matterhorn. Change of plans, they're actually doing a performance, and that sounds really cool. So we're gonna go and see that.
show we just watched was called the Pump Up Pep Rally, and basically it had like cheerleaders and dancers, and there was also like a drum line. Mom, did it take you back to the good old days of high school marching band?
It sure did.
That's awesome. Okay, now we're gonna get some more rides in, starting with our earlier fave, the Matterhorn. So I just got off the Matterhorn. Right now, we're about to go to this icy place. So there are literally 16 different spigots, or whatever they're called, of the slushy.
We are on the way.
I just finished up my slushie. I got three different flavors, blue raspberry, raspberry lemonade, and orange. And we were just watching a show by The Swell Tones. They're a singing group that does songs from all eras in the style of the 60s. They were really good. It was a fun show. And now we're about to head on to the Iron Dragon. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, man. So we just got off the Iron Dragon. That was a real stomach turner. It was great though. So basically how they're doing that ride is that in every four person little capsule thingy, they will seat two people in for every four seats. And as usual, they have these staggered exits and queue markers. Also in the bigger rides, they do have little TVs in the line that you can watch while you wait. It's called Cedar Point Fun TV. They have stuff like ads for different things you can buy at Cedar Point, general COVID platitudes, Cedar Point trivia, and music videos, and weather forecasts. So that's always fun to watch. Next, my mom and I, we're gonna find some lunch because we are hungry. So my mom and I, we just got some Panda Express. We got rice, orange, that's not anywhere near the food. We got rice, orange chicken, noodles, the works. So we're gonna enjoy lunch, and then once we're done, we're gonna resume our parking. Theme parking, not like parking a car. So we just finished our delightful lunch. We had some Chinese food, it was great. And now we're gonna go see what other rides there are to go on. We're hoping to go on the Cedar Creek Mine Ride next.
Unfortunately, the Wave Swinger does not appear to be open, so we're gonna be looking for Cedar Creek Mine. After spending way too long trying to find this ride date, we are going to go on the Cedar Creek Mine Ride. The ride's so great, I'm naming my vlogs after it.
So we just finished riding the Cedar Creek Mine Ride, and now we're just sort of walking around looking for the next thing to do here. Don't really have any plans at the moment.
So we were gonna try and get on the Gemini, but it's not operating today. So we're gonna get on the Lake Erie Eagles, and then hopefully after that, the Monsters.
So we just finished up on the Lake Erie Eagles. That was fun. It looks like the Monster is not open for operating. So looks like we're gonna have to find something else to do next. So we are about to get on the Sky Ride, which is pretty similar to what the Skyliner is in Disney World. So more so transportation than an actual ride. But it is quite enjoyable.
So we just got off the sky ride and now we're at the whole other end of the park. And you know what's great about that? Is that we are right by Topps Ice Cream. So we're gonna get in there and try some of their world famous giant scoops.
So we tried Topps and it was really good. And the scoops were pretty big. I tried the Brownie Bandit, which I think is themed after one of the rides, I'm not sure. But that was really good. And I just realized I'm wearing sunglasses inside. My mom,
she got the salted caramel fudge truffle. And I tried a little bit of that. It was also pretty good, but I think I liked my brownie flavor better.
So now we're probably gonna ride the carousel and do other things.
So we are about to go on the carousel because Topps is right there. We just need to wait for them to finish cleaning it and we'll be all clear. Okay, so we just finished up on the Midway carousel. An important thing to note is that this ride does not have a staggered exit like the other ones do. You just sort of exit when it's over. However, it does leave every other row empty. Now we are heading into the French Quarter. Oh my gosh, it smells so good in here. And this is a new store that they have here. They sell funnel cakes and ice cream and stuff. And we're gonna check it out since it's brand new.
So there are some pretty fun things on the menu, like s'mores funnel cake, fruity pebbles funnel cake. You can build your own funnel cake, waffle, or elephant ear. And they also have bottled water and other beverages and ice cream.
So we wanted to go on the Cedar Downs, but those were not open. And I'm pretty sure we've ridden just about everything we wanted to that was open. Some of the rides that are not operating at the moment are Gemini, we think the Blue Streak, the Monster, the Cedar Downs, Power Tower. Top Thrill Dragster was on for a little bit, but not very long. But now we are headed into the Snoopy Boutique to get some AC, look at some cool merch.
This is really cool. They have some space-themed Peanuts merchandise, which is, in my opinion, very cute. So for anyone who wasn't aware, Cedar Fair, the company, they don't own the rights, but like Peanuts can license out to them, which is why you'll see so many different Snoopy things laying around in merchandise stores.
So it looks like at the moment fitting rooms are closed, at least here in the Snoopy Boutique. It could be different in other locations, but personally,
is cute. They have these shelves filled with merchandise dedicated to one specific character. Like this one is Marcy. If we keep going, you'll see Peppermint Patty. We got Franklin. And Schroeder. It's nice to see some of the more peripheral characters getting some love here.
Okay, so we just went into I don't remember the exact name, but it's called like the Cedar Point Sweet Shop or something. So one important thing of note is that this is attached to the Snoopy Boutique and you can usually go between the two, but at the moment you cannot, which is understandable, but it is good information to have. So we just got out of the sweet shop. If you were wondering, we didn't buy anything from the gift shops, but now we're gonna head on to the Cadillac cars. Got me a Cadillac car. I don't know the rest of this song because I've only listened to it like one time. So,
Attention, don't be a short pause for a patient. Just hand us your card. Thank you for your patience.
So the antique cars, which are over in Yeehaw Cedar Point, those are not open right now. But I'm pretty sure this is basically the same thing. So if you've got a car fan in your family, prepare them for that. Okay. We just finished driving around the Cadillac cars, and I think I did a pretty good job considering I've had to renew my temps at least twice because I just keep not taking my driving test. But I feel proud of the way that I drove. There were no accidents. So now we're gonna head to the Pagoda gift shop and see what kinds of fun and goodies they have in there.
Have a lot of merchandise meant to commemorate the 150th anniversary. We got some shirts, long sleeve shirts, bags, and even like bottles and cups. We found a place that sells French fries. After all this time, we will be able to have those famous Cedar Point fries. The legendary Cedar Point fries and water.
We just finished our snack and now we are on a mission to find the railroad. We're gonna ride in the train.
We finally found the train after getting some help from a very kind security guard. And now we're about to ride the train.
We just finished our trip on the railroad. We did not take a round trip. And I think we've officially ridden everything we wanted to ride that we could ride. So now we're gonna start doing re-rides, starting with the classic, the one, the only, the Iron Dragon. Okay, so we just finished our re-ride of Cedar Creek Mine Ride, and it was
Iron Dragon,
and it was great. So now we are kind of just walking and seeing if there's anything else that we want to give another whirl. Okay, so we are headed back onto the Scrambler, and then after that, we're gonna go on the Sky Ride to the other end of the park. Okay, we just finished up on the Scrambler. It was, as they might say, a real scrambler. Now, we're gonna get some drinks and then head on the Sky Ride. So we just finished our ride on the Skyliner, and it's about 45 minutes to close, so we're heading out currently. But we might get in a few more rides at the last minute.
Right now, we're looking inside of the store that's underneath the Skyliner, and for some reason I feel like I should whisper in here like it's a library. I don't know, this place is just giving me a library vibe. So this is just some standard Cedar Point merchandise.
Okay, so we're gonna try and get on the carousel one last time before we go. We'll see if it is loading currently. So it looks like we're gonna be able to go on the carousel, so that's probably gonna be the last thing we do before leaving. So we just finished our ride on the carousel, and that's gonna be it for us today. Also, one thing you might have been wondering about is that, as far as I could tell, none of the indoor shows were happening. However, they are still doing outdoor ones like the Pump Up Pep Rally and the Swell Tones, like you saw earlier. So if you were wondering about that, and that's what's happening. My mom and I, we're gonna get some ice water before we leave. Thank you for tuning into the first episode of my Cedar Point vlogs. Remember, if I make it to 20 subs, I will ride the pipe scream, and I will probably cry. Thank you for tuning in.